This video is about the determinants of glomerular filtration rate. As in the previous videos, you learned about the process of the glomerular filtration and then the glomerular filtration rate, that at which rate, what are the quantities and the amounts of the filtrate that are produced by the glomerular capillaries. So the filtrate that is produced by the blood in the glomerular capillaries. So this filtrate is formed by the certain fresh pressures involved in these glomerular capillaries. So these pressures that are involved in the formation of the filtrate, they are the determinants that are responsible for the formation of the glomerular filtrate. So what are these determinants, or what are these pressures that determines the glomerular filtration rate? These pressures are the pressure that is generated by the blood inside the glomerular capillary, so known as the glomerular capillary pressure. The colloidal osmotic pressure in the glomeruli, this is the resistance pressure created by the plasma proteins present inside the glomeruli. Third is the hydrostatic pressure in the Bowman's capsule, as the filtrate present in the Bowman's capsule also causes the resistance force towards the glomerular capillaries. So these three are the pressures that determines the rate of the glomerular filtrate. Glomerular capillary pressure is created by the blood inside these capillaries. As the blood enters to the efferent arteriole, and then the filtrate is formed in the Bowman's capsule, as the blood is filtered out from these glomerular capillaries inside the Bowman's capsule, and the rest of the blood comes out from the efferent arteriole. So the efferent arteriole and the efferent arteriole, these two arterioles are different in diameter. Efferent arteriole has larger diameter as compared to the efferent arteriole. So because of the larger diameter, the large volume of the blood enters into the capillaries, while leaving the small amount are going out of the efferent arteriole. So this large volume of blood, when comes inside, it creates the pressure, as the outgoing passage is narrow. So this creates the pressure inside the glomerular capillaries. So because of this hydrostatic pressure, the plasma and the small particles and the solutes, they easily pass through, cross through the membrane and enters into the Bowman's capsule and leads to the formation of the filtrate. So the glomerular capillary pressure, this is the pressure that is developed by the blood that is present inside the glomerular capillaries, as because of the efferent arteriole, it has the larger diameter, so large volume of the blood comes inside the capillaries, and while leaving, it has the small route for going out of these capillaries, as the efferent arteriole has smaller in size. So because of this, a pressure will be created and the blood will have the advantage to stay in the capillaries for a more time, and then as compared to leaving this arteriole. So as the pressure is creating the glomerular capillaries, so the plasma and the solutes and the soluble substances will pass through it and will form the formation of the filtrate. So the filtrate that is formed by this pressure, the glomerular capillary pressure, it is about 60 millimeter Hg. So Hg is for the mercury. So 60 millimeter as Hg mercury, it is the unit of the pressure. So this pressure that is created by the blood in the glomerular capillaries, it is about 60 millimeter mercury, and this value also varies. It depends, and it varies between 45 to 70 millimeter Hg, but the range is between this 45 and 70. This pressure will be always present for the normal capillary working, or for the normal capillary pressure. These values will be varying between 45 to 70 millimeter Hg. So this was about the glomerular capillary pressure. So this is the one type of the pressure that is exerted by the blood present inside the glomerular capillaries. The second type of pressure is the okay so this pressure is the favoring pressure for the glomerular filtration, that because the filtrate is formed because of the this pressure, glomerular filtration pressure. So this pressure actually it favors the glomerular filtration. The other type of pressure that is involved is the colloidal osmotic pressure in the glomeruli. So this is the opposing pressure, as it is opposite to that of the glomerular capillary pressure. So it is also known as oncotic pressure, as the during the filtrate formation, all these plasma and the solute particles and the small particles filtered out of these glomerular capillaries. But the plasma proteins, as they are larger in size, they inside these glomerular capillaries, and then they go out and they leave these capillaries to the efferent arteriole. So the plasma proteins and the large proteins, they don't pass through these capillaries because they're larger in size, and they will stay inside these capillaries. So when the plasma proteins, they will be inside these capillaries and will stay there, what will happen that they will oppose the hydrostatic pressure of the glomerular capillaries. How? When these plasma proteins, they stay inside the glomerular capillaries, they tends to form the oncotic pressure for the glomerular capillaries, that all the water and all the plasma does not diffuse out from these capillaries. It has to make sure that if all the water diffuse out from these glomerular capillaries, then all the cells and the plasma will become concentrated. So to prevent these and to maintain the homeostasis of the blood vessels and to maintain the osmolarity and to protect the osmotic pressure, oncotic pressure of these capillaries, there is the resisting force that is applied by the glomerular capillary. So this is known as the colloidal osmotic, that it has to maintain the osmolarity of the capillaries, that the all of the materials don't tend to be escaped from the capillaries to the filtrate. So some of the amount which have to be remained in these capillaries, so there will be the opposing force that is known as the colloidal osmotic pressure. So as the blood vessels have the osmotic regularity, that they have to maintain all the materials tends to be flowing inside the blood vessels. So same like that, the glomerular capillaries also, there is the opposing force that keeps the materials and the plasma and that is created by the plasma proteins. As the plasma proteins remains in there, so they don't allow the blood to diffuse completely out of these capillaries and to form the filtrate, but some amount of the water and other solutes are also retained in these capillaries to maintain the homeostasis of the blood, to maintain the homeostatic environment of these substances. So colloidal osmotic pressure, that is the opposite of the hydrostatic pressure or the glomerular capillary pressure, that resists the diffusion of all the substances out of the capillaries. So this pressure, what are the amount or what are the quantities for this pressure? It is about 25 mm Hg. So the pressure that is created by this opposing force by the glomerular capillaries, that not to diffuse all of the substances through these capillaries and to maintain the homeostasis of these blood and the capillaries. So this colloidal osmotic pressure in the glomeruli, it is about 25 mm Hg, and this is the opposing, that it opposes the glomerular filtration rate. So as compared to the glomerular filtration rate, as the first pressure we have studied, in the glomerular filtration pressure, that it favored the filtration. So when the glomerular filtration rate is high, the filtrate formation will be high. While in case of the colloidal osmotic pressure, it is the opposite of the glomerular osmotic pressure that it opposes. So it will be inverse. If the colloidal osmotic pressure is high, then the formation of the filtrate will be less. But when if the colloidal osmotic pressure is low, then the formation of the filtrate will be more, because more of the substances and plasma will be diffused out from these capillaries. So this colloidal osmotic pressure is inverse of the filtrate. So it is the opposing force that it does not allow the leakage of all the substances to pass through it. The other pressure is the hydrostatic pressure in the Bowman's capsule. So there is the third pressure, that is the opposing pressure that is created by the Bowman's capsule. As the filtrate is, as the blood is filtered to form the filtrate to the glomerular capillaries, as we studied about the one pressure, that is the hydrostatic pressure or the glomerular capillary pressure that allows the filtrate to come into the Bowman's capsule. The other was the opposing force that was created by the glomerular colloidal pressure of the glomeruli. So the third pressure that is created by the filtrate, as the filtrate is formed and the filtrate is accumulated in the Bowman's capsule. So the third pressure is created by the filtrate that is present in the Bowman's capsule. That it also opposes the glomerular capillaries that to not allow the all the substances or all the plasma to leak out from these capillaries. So the amount of the filtrate is also responsible for the opposing action of these filtrate. So there are the favoring pressure, that is the glomerular capillary pressure, and two opposing pressure. The one opposing pressure is the colloidal osmotic pressure, and the second opposing pressure is the hydrostatic pressure that is created by the filtrate present in the Bowman's capsule. So this pressure, hydrostatic pressure by the Bowman's capsule or the filtrate present in the Bowman capsule, it is about 50 millimeter mercury. And these two pressures, as the hydrostatic pressure and the colloidal osmotic pressure of the glomerular capillaries, these two forces are the opposing forces that resist these filtrate formation. So these are the three pressures that collectively responsible for the formation of the glomerular filtrate.